we're going to uncover one of the greatest trickeries in history.
Kuko kuri uyu mugoroba tugiye gupfukura gukuraho inyegamo turebe bimwe mu binyoma bikomeye.
Sometimes things aren't really real, or they don't really seem to be real as they appear.
Hari igihe ibintu bigaragara nk'ibirimo urujijo, ukuri kwabyo ntigusobanuke neza.
For many, many years, hundreds of years, scientists thought the earth was the stationary center of the universe.
Mu myaka myinshi ishize, abantu benshi bari bazi ko uyu mubumbe w'isi ariho nyine umutima w'ibyaremwe byose.
So the earth stood still.
Nuko bagatekereza bati isi yahagararaga yemye.
And the sun and all the other planets,
maze izuba n'indi mibumbe,
they went around the earth,
byo bikazenguruka isi.
Well, that wasn't right.
Ibyo ntabwo byari ukuri.
A man named Copernicus,
nuko incabwenge yitwa Copernicus,
he determined that the earth itself was moving.
Aravuga atari ko isi nayo ubwayo irazenguruka.
And the earth actually revolved around the sun.
Kandi isi izenguruka izuba.
Well, it is possible.
Birashoboka.
Just as in Christ time.
Nkuko byari biri mu minsi ya Yesu.
That his church could be setting aside a commandment of God.
Yuko itorero ryaba riri gushyira ku ruhande itegeko ry'Imana.
To follow tradition rather than God's law.
Maze abantu bagakurikira ibihimbano by'abantu aho gukurikira itegeko ry'Imana.
So let's come back to what we've told you before.
Reka rero tugaruke ku byo twavuze mbere.
If it's in the Bible,
niba kiri muri Bibiliya,
I believe it.
Ndakizera.
If it disagrees with the Bible,
niba kitemeranya na Bibiliya,
then it's not for me.
Icyo si cyanjye.
You check it out in your own Bible.
Jukigerageresha Bibiliya yawe.
Well, the book of Revelation predicts that Satan would attempt to mislead the Christian church.
Igitabo cy'ibyahishuwe kiravuga ngo Satan azagerageza kuyobya abizera.
Let's look at Revelation 12 verse 9.
Byahishuwe igice cya 12 umurongo wa 9.
Oh, that great dragon was cast out.
Nuko cya kiyoka kinini kiracibwa.
Okay, the dragon has another name, the serpent of old.
Icyo kiyoka gifite irindi zina, ya nzoka ya kera.
Has another name called the devil.
Gifite irindi zina, cyitwa umwanzi.
Another name, Satan.
Gifite irindi zina, ni Satani.
And he deceives the whole world.
Aricyo kiyobya abari mu isi.
He was cast to this earth.
Kijugunywa mu isi.
And his angels were cast out with him.
Abamarayika bacyo bajugunywa nacyo.
Now we have discovered that Satan is a liar.
Twamaze kuvumbura ko Satani ari umubeshyi.
Satan deceives.
Satani ni umushukanyi.
His goal is to overthrow God's throne.
Intego ye ni uguhirika ubutegetsi bw'Imana.
So Satan attacked God's law.
Satani rero yagabye igitero ku mategeko y'Imana.
Right in the very center of those 10 commandments.
Kwikubitiro ahera mu ntimatima y'amategeko y'Imana.
The only commandment that says remember.
Maze agaba igitero kuri rya tegeko rivuga ngo wibuke.
Satan attacked the commandment about the Sabbath.
Satani yagabye igitero ku itegeko rivuga isabato.
Now isn't it logical?
Mbese nibyaba binyuze mu nyurabwenge.
That Satan, who is a deceiver,
kumva ko Satani w'umushukanyi
would attack the creator,
yagaba igitero ku muremyi,
by challenging the very symbol of his creation,
arwanya ikimenyetso kirema,
the Sabbath,
isabato,
the very day God said remember.
Wa munsi Imana yavuze iti jya wibuka.
There are many Christians, they're good-hearted Christians.
Hari abakristo benshi bakunda Imana.
They read the 10 commandments.
Basoma amategeko 10.
written with God's own finger,
yayanditswe n'urutoke rw'Imana,
written in stone,
akandikwa ku bisate by'amabuye,
and they look at the fourth commandment,
maze bakareba itegeko rya kane,
which tells us,
ritubwira ngo,
remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Wibuke kweza umunsi w'isabato.
6 days you will work.
Mumisi tandatu wo ugikora.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath.
Ariko akarindwi ni isabato.
Of the Lord your God.
Y'umwami Imana yawe.
So people read that, Christians read that, and they get confused.
Abakristo bamwe bakabisoma maze bakajya mu rujijo.
Because they say, but the church I go to worships on Sunday.
Maze bakavuga batariko se ko tujya kuruhuka ku cyumweru bite.
And that's the first day of the week.
Kandi uwo ni umunsi wa mbere.
It's not the seventh day Sabbath.
Ntabwo ari umunsi wa karindwi.
Many honest Christians read in the Bible.
Abakristo benshi babikuye ku mutima basoma muri Bibiliya.
In Luke 4:16.
Muri Luka igice cy'akano umurongo wa 16.
That Jesus, as his custom was,
yuko Yesu nkuko yari yaramenyereye,
went to the synagogue or the church on the seventh day Sabbath.
Yagiye mu isinagogi cyangwa mu rusengero ku munsi w'isabato.
They read that Matthew said in Matthew 24.
Basoma ko Matayo yabivuze mu gice cya 24 umurongo wa 20.
And in verse 20.
Umurongo wa 20.
That his disciples would be keeping the Sabbath 40 years after the cross.
Yuko abigishwa be bazakomeza kumvira amategeko nyuma y'imyaka 40.
Christians then read in Acts chapter 13.
Abo bakristo bakanasoma ibyakozwe n'intumwa igice cya 13.
That Paul taught a whole city to keep the seventh day Sabbath.
Paulo yabwirije umudugudu wose kuruhuka ku munsi w'isabato.
Well, who changed the Bible Sabbath?
Ninde wahinduye isabato ya Bibiliya?
God did not.
Imana siyo yabikoze.
The Bible says in Malachi 3 verse 6.
Bibiliya irambwira muri Malakiya igice cy'akabiri umurongo wa 6 umurongo wa 6.
For I am the Lord.
Kuko ndi Imana.
I do not change.
Je simpinduka.
Well, they look at the Bible.
Nuko bakareba muri Bibiliya.
And they see that Jesus didn't change the Sabbath.
Bakabona ko na Yesu atahinduye isabato.
Because Hebrews 13 verse 8.
Kuko mu Baheburayo igice cya 13 umurongo wa 8 havuga,
Jesus Christ is the same,
Yesu uko yarari,
yesterday,
ejo,
today,
n'uyu munsi,
and forever.
Niko ari kandi niko azahora iteka ryose.
Okay, so God didn't change the Sabbath.
Imana rero ntiyahinduye isabato.
Jesus would not change the Sabbath.
Yesu ntabwo yayihinduye.
And the disciples could not change the Sabbath.
Abigishwa nta bushobozi bari bafite bwo kuyihindura.
Well, let's look at Acts 5:29.
Ariko reka turebe mu byakozwe n'intumwa igice cya 5 umurongo wa 29.
Peter and the other apostles answered and said,
Petero n'izindi ntumwa barasubiza bati,
we ought to obey God rather than man.
Ibikwiriye n'ukumvira Imana kuruta abantu.
So the question comes back to us.
Aho rero hakagaruka ikibazo.
God didn't change the Sabbath.
Imana ntiyahinduye isabato.
Jesus would not change the Sabbath.
Yesu ntiyahinduye isabato.
The disciples couldn't change the Sabbath.
Abigishwa ntibayihinduye.
So who did change the Sabbath?
Ninde wahinduye isabato?
Well, in the book of Revelation chapter 13.
Igitabo cy'Ibyahishuwe igice cya 13.
Then I stood on the sand of the sea.
Nuko ngihagarara ku musenyi wo ku nyanja.
And I saw a beast rising up out of the sea.
Ngiye kubona mbona inyamaswa iva mu nyanja.
Having 7 heads.
Ifite imitwe irindwi.
And 10 horns.
Ifite amahembe 10.
And on his horns 10 crowns.
Ku mahembe yayo hari ibisingo 10.
And on his heads a blasphemous name.
No kumitwe yayo hariho amazina yo gutuka Imana.
Okay, this is a fascinating prophecy.
Ubu ni ubuhanuzi nkora mutima dukwiriye kumva.
You see, a beast in the Bible can be a political or a religious power.
Inyamaswa muri Bibiliya bishobora kuba ubutegetsi bw'idini cyangwa ubutegetsi bwa leta mu bya politiki.
This particular power rising up is a blasphemous power.
Ubu butegetsi buzamutse ni ubutegetsi butuka Imana.
That's kind of a big technical term.
Ahari iri jambo gutuka Imana ntabwo ryoroheye abantu kumva.
What it means is that it claims rights and powers that only God has.
Ariko icyo bivuga ni uko iyi nyamaswa cyangwa ubu butegetsi bushaka kwimura Imana bukafata ubutegetsi bwayo.
You know, if some human being starts saying, I can do this and I can do that and I'm all powerful just like God, you're being blasphemous.
Umuntu atangiye kuvuga ati je ndi igihangange ibi nabikora Imana ibyikora nage nabikora, uwo muntu abatutse Imana.
Okay, now the verse continues.
Nuko rero umurongo urakomeza.
And it says, the beast which I saw was like a leopard.
Uwo murongo ukavugwa ngo inyamaswa nabonye yasaga n'ingwe.
His feet were like the feet of a bear.
Amajanja yayo yasaga n'ayaruko.
Now remember these animals.
Reka twibukiranye iby'izi nyamaswa.
We're going to see them again shortly.
Turongera tuzirebeho gatoya.
All right, Daniel chapter 7 verse 2.
Danieli igice cya karindwi umurongo wa kabiri.
Daniel spoke saying,
Danieli aravuga ati,
I saw in my vision by night,
mu byo neretswe nijoro,
and behold the four winds of heaven,
nagiye kubona mbona imiyaga ine yo mu ijuru,
were stirring up the great sea,
ihubukira ku nyanja nini,
and four beasts came up from the sea.
Nuko inyamaswa enye ziva mu nyanja.
Each different from the other.
Buri nyamaswa itandukanye n'indi.
Now, notice this key to interpret Bible prophecy.
Reka tumenye urufunguzo rw'ubusobanuro bw'ubuhanuzi bwa Bibiliya.
Verse 17 of chapter 7.
Murongo wa 17 w'igice cya 7.
Those great beasts.
Izo nyamaswa nini ukwarenye.
Which are four.
Ukwarenye.
Are four kings which arise out of the earth.
Nibo bami bane bazaduka mu isi.
Verse 23.
Murongo wa 23.
Thus he said, the fourth beast shall be a fourth kingdom on earth.
Aravuga ati inyamaswa ya kane izaba ubwami bwa kane.
So Daniel sees four beasts that represent four kingdoms.
Danieli abonye inyamaswa enye bivuga ubutegetsi cyangwa ubwami bune.
These four world ruling kingdoms, they start in Daniel's day and they take us down the stream of time.
Ubu bwami bwatangiye mu bihe bya Danieli, none buratujyanye butugejeje ku musozo w'ibihe.
Now if you were here on that first night a week ago.
Niba wari hano mu cyumweru gishize ku munsi twabanje.
Kind of hard to believe a whole week has gone by.
Ndibwira ko icyumweru gishize sinarimbizi rwose ko kirangiye.
We talked about Daniel chapter 2.
Ariko twaganiriye kuri Danieli igice cya kabiri.
We saw those four kingdoms.
Twabonye ubwami bune.
I'm so proud of those people that came up here. They have not missed one night.
Ntewe ishema na ba bantu baje hano bagahamya ko batigeze basiba habe n'umugoroba umwe.
Some of you who came late, you didn't know those, you didn't see those people.
Abaje bakererewe ntimwabashije kubona abo bantu.
But one week ago we talked about those four different kingdoms.
Ariko mu cyumweru gishize twavuze kuri ubwo bwami bune.
Babylon, Medo-Persia, Greece and Rome, and then
Babuloni, Abamedi n'Abaperesi, Ubugiriki, Roma, hanyuma
divided kingdoms in Europe. That's what the feet represented.
Ubwami bwigabye mu bice mu Burayi.
The iron and clay would not mix.
Kuko icyondo n'icyuma bitashoboraga guhuzwa.
Now the vision of the beast adds more information to Daniel 2's vision.
Iyerekwa ry'izi nyamaswa ryatumye Daniel asobanukirwa neza.
During the time of the divided Europe in the toes and the feet of the statue,
mu gihe ubwami bwo mu Burayi bwigabanyaga mu bice aho tugeze ku mano ya cya gishushanyo cyo muri Danieli,
there would be a power that would rise up,
hari ubwami bwazamutse,
and of all things to change God's law.
Kandi nibwo bwami bwahinduye itegeko ry'Imana.
It would attempt to change God's law.
N'ubwami bwajyaga kugerageza guhindura itegeko ry'Imana.
Because you and I know tonight.
Kuko je namwe dusobanukiwe kuri uyu mugoroba.
Because we studied it last night.
Kuko twabyize ejo hashize.
And many of us have known for a long time.
Kandi benshi muri twe bamaze igihe babizi.
That the fourth commandment says remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Kuko itegeko rya kane rivuga ngo jya wibuka kweza umunsi w'isabato.
So this power has attempted to change things, but many of us know better.
Nikoko ubu butegetsi bwashatse guhindura itegeko ry'Imana ariko abenshi muri twe twamaze kumenya ayo mayeri.
Look at how the Bible predicted what would actually happen.
Reka turebe uko Bibiliya yahanuye ibyajyaga kuba.
Verse 4 of chapter 7.
Igice cya karindwi umurongo wa kane igitabo cya Danieli.
The first was like a lion.
Inyamaswa ya mbere yasaga n'intare kandi yari ifite amababa nk'ay'ikizu. Nyihanga amaso kugeza ubwo amababa yayo akuweho nk'umuntu, ihagarara ku isi, ihagarara ku maguru yayo yombi nk'umuntu, kandi ihabwa umutima nk'umuntu. Nuko rero inyamaswa ya mbere yasaga n'intare ifite amababa nk'ay'ikizu. Igihe abiga ibyo mu butaka mu isi bacukuraga bakagera i Babuloni, basanze ku nsika za Babuloni hari intare ifite amababa. Abo mu gihe cya kera b'i Babuloni, nk'uko abantu benshi babizi muri icyo gihe, ubwami bwabo bwari bufite ikimenyetso cy'intare. Ariko nyuma yaho irindi shyanga riza guhaguruka. Umurongo wa gatanu.
Suddenly another beast, a second like a bear.
Ako kanya haza indi nyamaswa isa n'idubu.
It was raised up on one side.
Kandi iyo nyamaswa yari ifite urubavu rumwe ruzamutse.
And had three ribs in its mouth.
Ndetse yari ifite imikaka eshatu mu kanwa kayo.
And they said thus to it.
Barayibwira bati.
Arise, devour much flesh.
Juka uconshomere inyama nyinshi.
So the second empire, which is like a bear,
nuko rero ubwami bwa kabiri busa n'idubu,
raises itself up on one side,
bwazamutse urubavu rumwe.
It is the combined kingdom,
ni ihuriro ry'ubwami,
of Media and Persia,
bw'Abamedi n'Abaperesi.
And they overthrew Babylon.
Ubwo nibwo bwatsinsuye Babuloni.
And the rising up on one side,
uko kuzamuka k'urubavu rumwe,
represented the Persians overthrowing first Babylon,
bigaragaza Abaperesi bahirika Babuloni ubwa mbere,
and then dominating the Medes,
maze bagategeka Abamedi.
And what's in the bear's mouth?
None se mu kanwa hari iki?
Three ribs.
Imikaka itatu.
When Medo-Persia conquered the world,
igihe Abamedi n'Abaperesi bari bamaze kwigarurira isi,
it first conquered Babylon.
Ubwa mbere bafashe Babuloni.
Then it went north,
nuko bajya mu majyaruguru,
conquered Lydia.
Bafata Libya.
Then it went south,
bajya mu majyepfo,
conquered Egypt.
Bafata Misiri.
So these three nations,
nuko ibihugu uko ari bitatu,
represent the three ribs.
Byagaragazaga iyi mikaka itatu.
Do you see how accurate Bible prophecy is?
Mbese murabona uko ubuhanuzi bwa Bibiliya ari impamo?
Well, a third empire arises.
Nuko ubwami bwa gatatu nabwo burazamuka.
Verse 6.
Umurongo wa gatandatu.
After this I looked.
Nkomeza kwitegereza nyuma y'ibyo.
And there was another like a leopard.
Mbona indi nyamaswa isa n'ingwe.
Which had on its back four wings of a bird.
Ku mugongo wayo yari ifite amababa ane.
The beast also had four heads.
Kandi iyo nyamaswa yari ifite imitwe ine.
And dominion was given to it.
Ihabwa ubutware.
So what was that third nation after Babylon and Medo-Persia?
Iyo nyamaswa ya gatatu nyuma ya Babuloni n'Abamedi n'Abaperesi.
Do you remember?
Murayibuka? niyihe
Greece
n'abagiriki.
Now what do you know about Greece?
Niki muzi kubagiriki?
Maybe some of you who have studied some of the ancient history.
Abagerageje kwiga amateka ya kera.
Who was the most prominent leader of ancient Greece?
Ninde muyobozi kabuhariwe wayoboye abagiriki?
Anybody know?
Ninde muzi?
Okay, who was it?
Yego ninde?
Ah,
Alexandri Mukuru.
Does that mean Alexander the Great?
Yeah, Alexandri Mukuru.
Mukuru. Okay. You're absolutely right.
Nibyo, ibyo uvuze n'ukuri.
He was just over 30 years of age when he conquered the then known world.
Ku myaka 30 gusa Alexandre yigaruriye isi yose.
He fit right into the age group that we prayed for tonight.
Nibyo yari muri ya myaka y'abantu tumaze gusengera kuri uyu mugoroba.
He conquered the world so quickly.
Kuko isi yayigaruriye n'umuvuduko mwinshi vuba cyane.
It was like a leopard with wings.
Yasaga n'ingwe igurukisha amababa.
Leopards are fast.
Muzi neza kw'ingwe zirangushye ziriruka cyane.
And if you add wings, they're really fast.
Niwe rero zihawe amababa murumva icyo byacura.
Of course this is all symbolic.
Mu byukuri ariko ibi ni ibimenyetso.
But why the four heads?
Ariko se iyi mitwe ine ni iyiki?
Look at how perfectly the beasts of Daniel line up with the four major world empires of.
Nimurebe rwose uko inyamaswa zo muri Daniyeli zihura mahwi n'ubutegetsi ubwami bwabayeho ku isi.
When Alexander the Great died,
igihe Alexandre Mukuru yatangaga,
he was only 33 years old.
Yari afite imyaka 33 gusa.
Usually a king would then either indicate or it would happen naturally that his son would become the next king.
Uko byagendaga iyo umwami yatangaga umuhungu we yagombaga kumusimbura ku ngoma.
But it didn't happen that way with Greece.
Ariko siko byagenze kubagiriki.
Instead of a son of Alexander taking over,
aho kugira ngo Alexandri agire umuhungu umusimbura,
his four major generals divided up the Greek empire.
Ahubwo abajenerali be abasirikari be bakuru bane bigabanyije ubutegetsi.
And each one took control over those four areas.
Nuko buri wese afata agace ke muri ibyo bice bine.
Isn't it amazing how the Bible predicted exactly what would happen?
Ese ntibitangaje kubona uko Bibiliya yasobanuye ibyajyaga kuba bigasohora?
You can count on the word of God.
Mukwiriye kwiringira ijambo ry'Imana.
The word of God is a foundation that you can depend on.
Uyu niwo musingi dukwiriye kubakiraho.
Well, the Bible describes a fourth empire.
Ariko Bibiliya ikomeza itubwira inyamaswa ya kane.
Verse 7 of chapter 7.
Umurongo wa karindwi w'igice cya karindwi.
After this I saw in the night visions.
Nuko nyuma y'ibyo mu nzozi zanjye za nijoro neretswe.
And behold a fourth beast.
Mbona inyamaswa ya kane.
Dreadful. Terrible.
Iteye ubwoba y'inyamaboko.
Exceedingly strong.
N'imbaraga nyinshi cyane.
It had huge iron teeth.
Yari ifite amenyo y'icyuma.
It was devouring. It was just chewing things up.
Yaconshomeraga ibyibonye byose.
Breaking in pieces.
Imenagura igasya.
And trampling the residue with its feet.
Inyukanyuka ibyari bisigaye.
It was different from all the beasts that were before it.
Iyo nyamaswa yari itandukanye n'izayibanjirije.
And it had 10 horns.
Kandi yari ifite amahembe icumi.
Now it's very clear that this fourth beast with iron teeth represented the iron kingdom of Rome.
Bisobanutse neza yuko inyamaswa yamenyo y'icyuma igereranya ubwami bw'abaroma.
This period takes us right down to the time of Christ.
Ibi rero biratujyana bikatugeza mu gihe cya Yesu.
Rome ruled the world in the days of Jesus.
Roma yatwaye isi mu gihe cya Yesu.
Christianity grew up in this Roman Empire.
Ubukristo bwazamukiye muri ubu bwami bw'abaroma.
Now the Bible describes the collapse of the Roman Empire.
Bibiliya kandi itubwira uko Roma yaje guhirima.
It explains about those feet and toes.
Ivuga iby'amano ikasobanura amano ya cya gishushanyo.
That statue of Daniel 2.
Cya kindi cyo muri Danieli gice cya kabiri.
And the horns of the fourth beast.
Ikatwereka n'iby'amahembe y'inyamaswa ya kane.
Now the image of Daniel 2 had feet and toes of iron.
Iki gishushanyo kuri Danieli nacyo kitwereka amano icumi.
And the clay representing Europe.
Hakatwereka nibumba uko ryari rimeze.
And the fourth beast shows those 10 horns.
Inyamaswa ya kane nayigaragaza amahembe cumi.
Rome was divided into 10 main divisions.
Roma yaje kwigabanyamo ubwami icumi.
During the time when the barbarian tribes were overrunning Europe.
Igihe ubwoko bwitwa barbaru bateraga Roma,
religious apostasy would enter into the church.
Nuko rero ubuhakanyi bwo mu idini bwinjiye mu itorero.
There would be a conflict over worship.
Hagombaga kuba intambara ishingiye kukuramya.
And the Sabbath would be changed.
Kandi sabato yagombaga guhindurwa.
Verse 8 of chapter 7.
Murongo wa 8 w'igice cy'7.
I was considering the horns.
Nuko nkomeza kwitegereza ya mahembe.
Now this is Daniel talking. He's the one who wrote the book of Daniel.
Uwo ni Daniel ubivuga, niwe wanditse iki gitabo.
I was considering these horns, looking at them.
Akomeza guhanga amaso ya mahembe.
And there was another horn.
Abona irindi hembe.
A little one.
Byari agahembe gato.
Coming up among them.
Kazamutse muri yo.
Now in Europe, among these 10 horns,
Muburayi muraya mahembe 10,
represented by the 10 horns and the 10 toes,
zigaragaza amano 10 cyangwa bwa bwami 10,
there's another power that starts to rise.
Hari ubundi bwami bwazamutse.
Now the Bible says,
Bibiliya iravuga ngo,
about this little tiny horn,
kuri aka gahembe gato,
before whom 3 of the first horns were plucked out by the roots.
Kameze mu cimbo cy'amahembe atatu yari yaranduwe n'imizi.
And there in this horn,
nuko muri ako gahembe,
that's this little horn,
ako gahembe gato,
where these 3 other horns were plucked up,
aho ngaho amahembe atatu yaranduwe,
were eyes like the eyes of a man.
Ako gahembe ngo kari gafite amaso ameze nk'ay'umuntu.
And a mouth speaking pompous or grandiose big words.
Kandi kari gafite akanwa kavuga ibikomeye.
The Bible says this little horn arose.
Bibiliya iravuga ngo igihe irihembe ryazamukaga aka gahembe gato.
And was different from all the others.
Kandi inyamaswa bikaba yari itandukanye n'izindi zose.
Now the holy word of God,
ijambo ry'Imana ryera,
the Bible,
Bibiliya,
gives us evidence to clearly identify this horn and power.
Riduhi bihamya ngo dushobore kumenya neza aka gahembe gato n'ububasha bwako.
Verse 8 of chapter 7 of Daniel.
Umurongo wa 7 wa 8 w'igice cy'7 cya Danieli.
First this little horn comes up among the first 10 horns.
Ubwa mbere aka gahembe gato gakomoka mu mahembe 10.
And so it's in Western Europe.
Bityo ni mu burengerazuba bw'Uburayi.
This little horn doesn't come up in Asia.
Ntabwo aka gahembe gakomotse muri Aziya.
Or in America.
Ntigakomotse muri Amerika.
Or here on this great and fantastic continent, Africa.
Cyangwa ngo kabe kavuye kuri uyu mugabane mwiza ukomeye w'Afurika.
Its roots are in Europe.
Ahubwo imizi ya gahembe gato iri mu Burayi.
Okay, so that's one identification.
Icyo ni igihamya cya mbere.
Secondly, the Bible says,
icya kabiri Bibiliya irabivuga,
that this little horn,
yuko ako gahembe gato,
would arise after the 10 horns.
Iryo hembe rito ryajyaga kumera nyuma y'amahembe 10.
So it doesn't come during the time of Babylon, Medo-Persia.
Ntabwo iri hembe ryaje mu gihe cy'Ababuloni cyangwa Abamedi n'Abaperesi.
Greece or Rome.
Ntabwo ryaje mu gihe cy'Abagiriki cyangwa Abaroma.
It comes up after the fall of Rome.
Ahubwo ryameze nyuma yo guhirima kw'ingoma y'Abamedi n'Abaperesi n'Abaroma n'ibindi byose.
It's a power that rises out of Rome.
Ni imbaraga cyangwa ububasha ubwami bwakomotse muri Roma ubwayo.
All right, the Bible also says that this little horn has eyes like the eyes of a man.
Bibirika nambwira ngo iryo hembe rito rifite amaso nk'ay'umuntu.
You can see it pictured up there at the very top of this strange looking beast.
Ushobora kugerageza kureba aho rishushanyije hariya kurusika.
Eyes represent intelligence.
Amaso ashushanya ubwenge n'ubushishozi.
But it is man's wisdom, not God's wisdom.
Ariko ubwo n'ubwenge nyabantu si ubwenge buva ku Mana.
It is a human religious system.
Ibi ni dini ya kimuntu.
Based on man's teaching,
yubakiye ku myigishirize y'abantu,
that would rise out of the end of the Roman Empire,
izakomoka mu kurimbuka k'ubwami bw'Ababuloni bwa Roma.
You see why I said this evening you must listen very carefully.
Muribuka rero ko nababwiye kuri uyu mugoroba nti nimutega amatwi mwitonze.
Don't let this presentation confuse you.
Ntimutume iki cyigisho kibasiga mu rujijo.
If you follow the biblical understanding,
nuramukurikije uko Bibiliya yigisha,
it will be very clear.
Biraza gusobanuka.
Notice what the Bible says in Daniel 7:24.
Reba icyo Bibiliya ivuga muri Daniyeli gice cya 7 umurongo wa 24.
It is diverse or different than all the rest.
Biravuga ngo iyi nyamaswa yari itandukanye n'izindi nyamaswa zayibanjirije.
There it says it right there in that verse 24.
Umurongo wa 24.
So it's not primarily a political power.
Mu mizo yaryo kwikubitiro ntabwo ari ubutegetsi bwa politiki.
It's actually a religious power.
Ahubwo ni ubutegetsi bw'idini.
It is a combination, actually.
N'uruhurirane.
A religio-political power.
N'uruhurirane rw'idini na politiki bikabyara ikintu kimwe.
Now, what would this little horn or this power try to do?
Irijambo irihembe rito ni iki ryagerageje gukora?
It would attempt to change the very law of God.
Ngo rizagerageza guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
Notice what verse 25 says.
Reba icyo umurongo wa 25 uvuga.
And he, that's this little horn with a mouth and with eyes.
Nuko iryo hembe rifite akanwa n'amaso.
He shall speak great words.
Rizavuga ibikomeye.
Against the Most High.
Rituka Imana.
And shall wear out the saints.
Nuko abera ribarimbure.
Of the Most High.
Abera bisumba byose.
The text finishes up by saying, and think, that's what this little horn, and think to change times and laws.
Umurongo usoza uvuga ngo azigira inama yo guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
The power would attempt to change God's law.
Ubu bubasha buzagerageza guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
Daniel 8:12.
Danieli igice cya 8 umurongo wa 12 hatubwira ngo,
tells us this little horn power would do the following.
Ubu butegetsi buzakora ibi bikurikira.
Cast truth down to the ground.
Iby'ukuri rizabijugunya hasi.
He did all this and prospered.
Kandi rizabikora risagambe.
So coming out of the old Roman Empire,
turamutse dusubiye ku bwami bw'Abaroma,
a religious power would arise.
Ubwami bwa kidini bwazamutse.
Very small to begin with.
Mwikwikubitiro bwari ubwami bworoheje.
But it would become very powerful.
Ariko buzamuka bugira imbaraga.
It would claim to have the authority to change God's law.
Maze rero ubwo bwami bukavuga ko bufite ububasha bwo guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
Now you might ask the question.
None ushobora kwibaza ikibazo.
How did the change from Sabbath to Sunday actually happen?
None byagenze bite ngo isabato isimbuzwe icyumweru?
What happened historically?
byagenze bite mu mateka?
Well, the changing of the Sabbath occurred gradually.
Mu byukuri guhinduka kw'isabato byaje ni ruto ni ruto.
Over a period of time.
Byatwaye igihe runaka.
And it resulted in a variety of social and religious factors.
Nuko biza kubyara idini n'abaturage ubwabo bibumbiye hamwe mu mibanire, nuko biza kuvamo ikintu gihindura isabato.
Now a particular scholar and a learned individual helps us to understand the roots of this change.
Umwanditsi w'umuhanga agerageza kutubwira imizi yihinduka ry'aya mategeko.
His name was Dr. Eddy.
Izina rye ni Dr. Eddy.
And in his Bible encyclopedia he says the following.
Mu busobanuro bwa Bibiliya dore uko avuga.
Sabbath, a Hebrew word signifying rest.
Isabato ijambo mu Giheburayo rivuga ikiruhuko.
Sunday was a name given by the heathens.
Umunsi wa mbere cyangwa ku cyumweru ni izina ryatanzwe n'abanyamahanga.
To the first day of the week.
Bariha umunsi wa mbere w'icyumweru nyine.
Because it was on the day on which they worshiped the sun.
Kuko ku cyumweru kuri uwo munsi wa mbere ari w'abanyamahanga n'abapagani bateraniraga hamwe ngo baramye Imana yabo izuba.
Sun worship was very common in Egypt.
Gusenga izuba byari ibintu bimenyerewe mu Misiri,
in Babylon and Persia and Rome,
muri Babuloni, muri Persia ni Roma.
You know, the sun gives strength and light and warmth.
Basengaga izuba kuko ryabahaga imbaraga, rikabaha ubushyuhe, rikabafasha byinshi.
So people who did not know the true God, they worshiped the sun.
Nuko rero abantu benshi batari bazi Imana y'ukuri basengaga izuba.
Oh, people used to worship all kinds of things.
Abantu basengaga ibintu binyuranye.
Even the moon or
hari n'abasengaga ukwezi n'inyenyeri.
Now when you come down to the 4th century after Christ,
iyo ugeze mu kinyejana cya kane nyuma ya Kristo,
there is a Roman emperor named Constantine.
Hari umwami w'abami w'umuroma witwaga Constantine.
He was a worshipper of the sun.
Uwo nawe yaramyaga izuba.
He even put the sun god on the coins that they minted or produced.
Ndetse ku biceri byabo bakoreshaga habaga hashushanyije Imana zuba.
So you have an emperor who loves the sun god.
Hano rero dufite umwami ukunda Imana zuba akanasenga izuba.
But he had a big problem.
Ariko yari afite ikibazo gikomeye.
Rome, that big empire, was falling apart.
Roma, ubwo bwami bukomeye bwari bugeze aharindimuka.
He wanted to unite it.
Yashakaga kubusubiza ubumwe bwabwo.
So how did he try to unite it?
Aravuga atari ku Roma nzayigira izagira ubumwe ite.
Oh, he thought he had a really good idea.
Maze aratekereza yigira inama nziza uko yabyibwiraga.
Why not unite the empire around Sunday?
Aravuga ati kugira ngo ubu butegetsi bwanjye bugire ingufu kandi bwe gusenyuka ndabuzanira umunsi wa mbere w'icyumweru.
The worship on Sunday.
Arababwira ati abo muri ubu bwami bazajya basenga ku munsi wa mbere w'icyumweru.
So in the year 321,
nuko muri 321,
he gave a decree,
ashyiraho iteka.
And he said,
aravuga ati,
on the venerable day of the sun,
ku munsi w'icyubahiro w'izuba,
let the magistrates and people residing in cities rest.
Reka bakora mu nkiko n'abakora mu mugi baruhuke.
And let all the shops be closed.
Reka amangazini yose ye kugururwa.
Constantine calls Sunday the venerable day of the sun.
Constantine ubwe imunsi ku cyumweru munsi wa mbere awita umunsi ukomeye w'izuba.
And he says that all the shops should be closed.
Kandi aciteka ngo amaduka yose azafungwe.
He attempted to unite his empire.
Yabikoze agerageza gukomeza no gushyira hamwe ubwami bwe
by issuing the first Sunday law.
Ashyiraho itegeko rya mbere ryo kuruhuka ku cyumweru.
In the days of Constantine, the church and state united.
Mu minsi y'ubutegetsi bwa Constantine, idini na leta byibumbiye hamwe.
To Christianize the pagans.
Kugira ngo bashobore guhindura abapagani baba abakristo.
People who didn't believe in the true God.
Abo bantu ntibizeraga Imana nzima.
And that way he thought he could unite the empire.
Muri ubwo buryo yatekerezaga ko ashobora guhuza ubwami bwe.
So the Roman government.
Nuko rero ubwami bw'abaroma, ubutegetsi bw'abaroma,
and the Roman church,
ndetse n'idini y'abaroma,
were united.
Byibumbiye hamwe.
You see why I said earlier this evening, you must listen well.
Ese muribuka ko tugitangira iki cyigisho nababwiye ngo mugenze mute mutega amatwi mwitonze.
So as these Christians wanted to distance themselves from the Jews,
nuko abakristo ubwo bashakaga kwitarura abayuda,
Sunday gradually became emphasized.
Icyumweru cyakomeje kugenda gihabwa imbaraga.
Because of Christ's resurrection on Sunday.
Ndetse bakavuga bati niwo munsi Yesu yazutseho.
And gradually church leaders,
nuko niruto niruto abayobozi b'idini,
to make the pagan sun worshipers more comfortable,
kugira ngo banezeze abaramya Imana zuba,
they started to keep Sunday in place of the Bible Sabbath.
Batangira kuruhuka ku cyumweru mu kimbo cyo kuruhuka isabato ya Bibiliya.
Constantine wanted to unite his empire.
Nuko umwami Constantine ashaka gukomeza ingoma ye.
And Roman church leaders wanted to convert the pagans.
Nuko rero abaroma nabo bakavuga bati dukwiriye guhindura abapagani.
So Sunday, the first day of the week, became a way to accomplish both.
Nuko icyumweru umunsi wa mbere gihinduka umuyoboro wo gusohoza ibyo byifuzo by'abantu.
So the biblical Sabbath,
nuko isabato ya Bibiliya,
the Sabbath you find in the fourth commandment,
isabato ubona mu itegeko rya kane,
that was never changed,
itarigeze ihinduka,
it's still here in this word,
iracyari muri iri jambo,
it will be valid throughout eternity,
izakomeza kubaho kugeza iteka ryose.
This biblical Sabbath,
iyi sabato ya Bibiliya,
was changed by the Roman church and state,
yahinduwe n'idini y'abaroma na leta.
God did not change it.
Imana siyo yahinduye iri tegeko.
The disciples didn't change it.
Abigishwa ntibayihinduye.
Jesus didn't change it.
Yesu ntiyayihinduye.
Now the Catholic Church Council of Laodicea.
Inama ikomeye ya Kiliziya Gatolika yabereye ahitwa Laodicea
records the first prohibition or law against keeping the Bible Sabbath.
Niyo ya mbere yamaganye kuruhuka umunsi w'isabato.
The Roman Catholic bishops met there and look what happened.
Abepiskopi ba Kiliziya Gatolika barahuye bumvikana ibi.
Is many many years ago.
Hashize imyaka myinshi.
325 AD.
Muri 325 nyuma ya Yesu.
The Council of Laodicea.
Niho inama y'Laodicea yabaye.
All right, listen to what it said.
Umva uko bavuze.
Christians shall not Judaize.
Abakristo ntibazagerageza kwigira abayuda.
In other words, that meant Christians should not keep the seventh day Sabbath.
Mu yandi magambo bari bavuze ngo abakristo ntibakaruhuka umunsi w'isabato.
And be idle on Saturday.
Kugira ngo bahinduke abanebwe be gukora ku munsi w'isabato.
You see, the Jewish people did not accept Jesus.
Abayuda ntabwo bemeraga Yesu.
And while Christians and Jews were keeping the seventh day Sabbath,
nuko mu gihe abayuda n'abakirisitu bose baruhukaga umunsi w'isabato,
and while pagans and others were fighting against Christians,
igihe abapagani n'abandi bantu barwanyaga abakirisitu,
and fighting against Jewish people,
banarwanya abayuda,
the Christian people didn't want to be connected with the Jewish people.
Abakirisitu batinye kubabazanywa n'abayuda baritarura
who didn't accept Jesus,
nuko ntibemeranya nabo batemeraga Yesu.
And so now it came to the point where they said Christians should not be like the Jews in keeping Sabbath.
Nuko baravuga bati ntihakagira abakristo basa n'abayuda bubahiriza umunsi w'isabato.
Well, it goes on.
Birakomeza.
And it says, but the Lord's day they shall especially honor.
Ariko baravuga bati iyi nama ya Odisea iravuga iti ariko umunsi w'Imana bajye bawumvira bawuruhukeho.
And as being Christians,
nuko nk'abakirisitu
shall, if possible,
bazakomeza niba bishoboka,
do no work on that day.
Kudakora kuri uwo munsi.
If, however, they are found Judaizing,
icyakora nibavumburwa bigira abayuda,
in other words, keeping the seventh day Sabbath,
baruhuka umunsi w'isabato,
they shall be shut out from Christ.
Abo ngabo bazabohwa batandukanywe na Kirisitu.
What a strange thing to say.
Oh, mbega ibintu biteye ubwoba kubivuga.
So here's a church council.
Hano hari inama y'idini.
That unites with Roman government.
Yihuje na leta y'Abaroma.
Under Constantine the emperor.
Bakaba bayobowe n'umwami Constantine.
And they say we're shifting the authority of Sabbath to Sunday.
Baravuga bati ububasha bw'isabato tubwimuriye ku cyumweru.
We will unite the empire.
Tuzahuza ubwami bwacu tubukomeze.
We're going to put some distance between us and the Jews.
Tuzashiraho umworera hagati yacu n'abayahudi.
And in so doing,
nitubigenza dutyo,
they were fulfilling Daniel's prophecy in verse 25.
Muri icyo gihe buzuzaga ubuhanuzi bwo muri Danieli igice cya 7 umurongo wa 25.
And shall think to change times and laws.
Azigira inama zo guhindura ibihe n'amategeko.
An earthly power would grow out of Rome and attempt to change God's law.
Ubutegetsi bwo kwisi bwavuye muri Roma buzamuka bushaka guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
Now listen to what the Converts Catechism says.
Reka twumve iki gatigisimu uwari wihanye asoma gatigisimu avuga.
This is a Roman Catholic instructional guide.
Igitabo cya gatigisimu ni kimwe kiyobora abaroma abakiriziya gatulika y'i Roma.
And this Catholic guide accurately or correctly talks about the change of the Sabbath.
Gatigisimu ya kiriziya gatulika isobanura neza uko bahinduye umunsi w'isabato bakawugera ku munsi wa mbere w'icyumweru.
It's very clear.
Irasobanutse.
The question.
Ikibazo.
Now this is in this catechism, all right?
Kandi mu byibuke ibi byanditswe mu ndongozi gatigisimu iyobora abakristo bakiriziya gatulika.
From the Roman Catholic Church.
Abakristo bakiriziya gatulika bafite indongozi bita gatigisimu.
Which is the Sabbath day?
Bafitemo ikibazo kibaza ngo isabato ni iyihe?
The answer is
igisubizo.
In this catechism,
muri yo gatigisimu,
Saturday is the Sabbath day.
Mu byukuri umunsi wa 7 niwo sabato.
Question.
Ikindi kibazo.
Why do we observe Sunday instead of Sabbath?
None se kuki turuhuka ku cyumweru ku munsi wa mbere aho kuruhuka ku isabato?
Now listen to this answer.
Umva igisubizo.
Because the Catholic Church transferred the solemnity or sacredness from Saturday to Sunday.
Kuko kiriziya gatulika yimuriye kwera ku isabato ikwimurira ku cyumweru.
Now let's go to the Catholic Encyclopedia.
Reka rero turebe inkoranyamagambo ya kiriziya gatulika.
I hope you listened carefully to what we were reading, those questions and answers.
Ndagira ngo mwakurikiranye ubwitonzi biriya bibazo n'ibisubizo byo muri gatigisimu twagerageje gusoma.
Okay, the Catholic Encyclopedia says.
Reka turebe mu nkoranyamagambo ya Kiliziya Gatulika.
The church, after changing the day of rest from the Jewish Sabbath,
idini rimaze guhindura umunsi w'isabato w'abayahudi rikabishira ku munsi wa mbere
of the seventh day of the week to the first,
ku munsi wa mbere w'iminsi 7,
made the third commandment refer to Sunday as the day to be kept holy as the Lord's day.
Kiriziya yategetse ku munsi wa mbere wezwa ukaruhukwa ukitwa umunsi w'umwami.
Now remember, just a little bit ago, we explained and found in the Bible.
Mubyibuke twagerageje gusobanura maze tubona muri Bibiliya.
That in Revelation, when it says, John says, I was in vision on the Lord's day.
Yuko igihe Yohana mu mayerekwa ye yavuze ati ku munsi w'umwami wanje.
We found out also in the New Testament that the Lord's day is the Sabbath.
Twabonye ku munsi w'umwami ari Isabato.
Well, I don't want you to be confused about this term Lord's day, all right?
Sinshaka ko mujijwa kubijyanye n'umunsi w'umwami.
Okay, so this Catholic encyclopedia tells us that the commandment regarding time.
Nuko rero iyi nkoranyamagambo ya Kiliziya Gatulika irivugira ubwayo ko itegeko rijyanye n'ibihe
had been changed by the church.
Byahinduwe na Kiliziya ubwayo.
Now, some may have noticed that this statement refers to the third commandment.
Ahari bamwe mwamaze kubona yuko iyi mpinduka yerekeza ku itegeko rya gatatu.
In my Bible,
muri Bibiliya yanjye,
the Sabbath is not the third commandment.
Isabato ntabwo ari itegeko rya gatatu.
Which commandment is it?
Ni irihe tegeko?
The fourth commandment.
Isabato ni itegeko rya kane.
All right, this is an important thing for you to remember.
Iki ni ikintu mukwiriye kwibuka.
The Roman power of the Middle Ages.
Nuko rero ubutegetsi bw'Abaroma bwo mu binyejana bya kera.
Also changed the law of God.
Nabo bahinduye itegeko ry'Imana.
That ten commandments that you have in your Bible.
Muri amategeko 10 mufite muri Bibiliya zanyu.
They changed it by removing the second commandment.
Bagerageje kubihindura itegeko rya kabiri bariteruramo.
The one that prohibits or says you are not supposed to worship images.
Itegeko ryategekaga ngo ntimukaramye bishushanyo baba bari kuyemo.
And they took the tenth commandment.
Maze bifatira itegeko rya 10.
Which says thou shalt not covet.
Rivuga ngo ntukifuze.
And they divided that one into two.
Barigabanyamwe amategeko abiri.
So they got rid of the second one.
Itegeko rya kabiri baba bararihiritse.
Moved the fourth to the third.
Maze irya gatatu baryimurira ku rya kane.
Divided the tenth one.
Irya 10 barigabamo kabiri.
So they ended up with 10.
Nuko bakoze imibare byuzura 10.
But not God's 10.
Ariko si Imana yabikoze.
Well, there's a very foremost Catholic scholar.
Dore umwanditsi umuhanga wakoze ku bya Kiliziya Gatulika.
And he wrote a book as a challenge to Protestants.
Yanditse igitabo gikwiriye gutekerezwaho cyane ku baporoso.
It's called Catholicism and Fundamentalism.
Ni igitabo yise ibya Gatulika n'ibyo kugendera ku mahame.
Okay, here's what he said.
Dore ibyo yavuze.
Fundamentalists meet for worship on Sunday.
Aravuga ati abantu bashingira ku mahame barahuye ngo baruhuke ku munsi wa mbere.
Yet there is no evidence in the Bible.
Ariko nta kimenyetso na kimwe muri Bibiliya.
That corporate worship, that means worshiping together.
Gihuriza gituma abantu bahurira hamwe.
Was to be made on Sundays.
Maze bakaruhuka ku cyumweru.
The Jewish Sabbath or the day of rest.
Isabato ya Kiyahudi cyangwa umunsi wo kuruhukwa.
Was of course Saturday.
Mu byukuri wari umunsi wa karindwi.
Now this is a Catholic scholar.
Uyu ni umuntu wajambuye mu bya Kiliziya Gatulika.
He goes on to say,
arakomeza avuga ati,
it was the Catholic Church that decided Sunday should be the day of worship for Christians.
Kiliziya Gatulika niyo yihitiyemo isimbura umunsi wa karindwi itegeka ko abantu baruhuka ku wa mbere.
In honor of the resurrection.
Kugira ngo icyo gihe bubahirize ikimenyetso cyo kuzuka kwa Yesu.
So this Catholic author is trying to reason with Protestants.
Uyu mu cyabwenge wa Kiliziya aragerageza gutekereza kimwe n'abaporoso.
He says if you want to go by the Bible.
Aravuga ati niba ushaka kumva icyo Bibiliya ivuga.
And let me tell you, as we say, if it isn't in the Bible, it's not for me.
Kandi nkuko mubyibuka niba kitari muri Bibiliya. si cyanje.
But if it's in the Bible, I believe it.
Ariko niba kiri muri Bibiliya ngenza nte, ndacyizera.
This Catholic author is saying, if you want to go by the Bible,
uyu rero umucabwenge wa Kiliziya Gatulika ati uramutse ugiye muri Bibiliya,
you should keep the Bible Sabbath.
Ukwiriye kumva ukaruhuka isabato ya Bibiliya.
If you don't want to go by the Bible,
niba udashaka kumva icyo Bibiliya ivuga,
you should go back to the Catholic Church.
Jya wiruhukira icyo Kiliziya Gatulika yategetse.
Because the Catholic Church claims the authority to change God's law.
Kuko Kiliziya Gatulika yiyemereye ko ifite ububasha bwo guhindura amategeko y'Imana.
Now this is a very powerful argument used by a Catholic scholar.
Ibingibi ni umwanditsi ukomeye wa Kiliziya Gatulika wabyivugiye.
You see, the issue is what is your guide?
Ikibazo gikomeye ni ukumenya ngo ninde muyobozi wawe.
Is it the holy word of God, the Bible?
Mbese urayoborwa n'ijambo ryera ry'Imana Bibiliya?
Or is it human tradition?
Cyangwa urayoborwa n'imigenzo y'abantu?
The Bible?
Bibiliya?
Or tradition.
Cyangwa imigenzo.
The issue is, does any human church or religious leader,
ikibazo ni iki ngo mbese umuntu idini cyangwa umuyobozi w'idini,
for whatever reason,
yagira impamvu yariyo yose,
have the authority to change God's law?
Mbese murabona afite ububasha n'impamvu byo guhindura itegeko ry'Imana?
You see why I said you need to listen tonight?
Mbese murumva impamvu nababwiye ngo mutege amatwi mwitonze?
This is serious business.
Ibi ni ibintu bikomeye cyane.
Psalm 89 verse 34.
Zaburi ya 89 umurongo wa 34.
God tells us,
Imana iratubwira ngo,
my covenant I will not break.
Isezerano ryanjye sinzaryica.
Nor alter or change the word that has gone out of my lips.
Sinzahindura na rimwe amagambo yasohotse mu kanwa kanjye.
What I spoke in Sinai and wrote with my finger,
ibyo navuze nkabyandikisha urutoke rwanjye ntibizahinduka.
I'm not going to change that.
Sinzabihindura.
It's a matter of authority.
Ni ikibazo cy'ububasha.
So the issue is, who is your master?
Noneho rero ikibazo ni iki ngo ninde muyobozi wawe, ninde mutware wawe?
Is it Jesus?
Mbese ni Yesu?
Or the leaders of the church?
Cyangwa n'abayobozi b'idini?
What's the foundation of your faith?
Umusingi wo kwizera kwawe ni uwuhe?
Is it the Bible?
Mbese ni Bibiliya?
Or is it what man says?
Cyangwa n'ibyo abantu bavuga?
What's the basis of authority in spiritual matters?
Ni uwuhe musingi dukwiriye kugenderaho mu bya mwuka?
The church or God's will?
Idini cyangwa ubushake bw'Imana?
All days are not alike.
Ntabwo iminsi yose isa.
Only one day was blessed by God.
Umunsi umwe gusa niwo wahawe umugisha n'Imana.
Only one day was sanctified by God.
Umunsi umwe gusa niwo wejejwe nayo.
Only one day was set apart by God.
Umunsi umwe gusa niwo washizwe ku ruhande.
It is the seventh day Sabbath.
Ni umunsi wa karindwi isabato y'Imana.
And God rested on that one day.
Kandi Imana yawuruhutseho.
You see, the issues that we are dealing with,
ibibazo duhanganye nabyo,
are issues of authority.
Ni ibibazo by'abafite ububasha.
Issues of obedience.
Ni ibibazo byo kumvira.
So our choice tonight,
guhitamo kwacu kuri uyu mugoroba,
right here in Gisenyi,
hano ku Gisenyi,
is it the Bible or tradition?
Mbese ni Bibiliya cyangwa ni ibihimbano?